The Road to Hampton Court by Alfred Sisley in 1874. Sisley was born and spent most of his life in France, but retained British citizenship. He was the most consistent of the Impressionists in his dedication to painting landscape outdoors. Two Women Chatting by the Sea Street Thomas by Camille Pissarro in 1856. Pissarro was a Danish-French painter born on the island of St. Thomas. His importance resides in his contributions to both Impressionism and Post-Impressionism. Golden Summer, Eaglemont by Sir Arthur Ernest Streeton in 1889. Streeton was an Australian landscape painter and leading member of the Heidelberg School. Also known as Australian Impressionism, he was made an Australian official war artist with the Australian Imperial Force, holding the rank of honorary lieutenant, and he traveled to France in 1918. Coastal Scene on a Cloudy Day by Carl Ludwig Filson Locker in 1874. Locker was a Danish realist painter who from an early age became a member of the Skagen group of painters. From an early age he took an interest in ships and received his first training from his father who painted ship portraits for a living. hanging the laundry out to dry by Berthe Morisot in 1875. Morisot was married to Eugene Manet, the brother of her friend and colleague Edouard Manet. She was described by Gustave Geffroy in 1894 as one of the three grand ladies of Impressionism alongside Marie Brackelmond and Mary Cassatt. The Fisherman's Cottage near Varengeville by Claude Monet in 1882. Monet was a French painter, a founder of French Impressionist painting and the most consistent and prolific practitioner of the movement's philosophy of expressing one's perceptions before nature, especially as applied to plein air landscape painting. The term Impressionism is derived from the title of his paintings. The Kingfishers by Emil Claus in 1891. Claus was a Belgian painter. He first successfully created portraits and genre paintings in the academic style. Before repeatedly spending time in Paris in the 1890s and adopting the painting style of the French Impressionists, River by Fritz Thaulow in 1883. Thaulow was a Norwegian Impressionist painter, best known for his naturalistic depictions of landscape. Thanks to him, among others, the so-called Autumn Exhibition, an annual presentation of contemporary art in Oslo, was established in 1882. Landscape with Horse Carriage and Stream by Carl Buchholz in 1882. Buchholz was a German landscape painter who worked in oils and watercolors. He also produced drawings and etchings. His output was rather small and his works are widely scattered. Waves by Karl Hagemeister in 1910. Hagemeister was a German landscape painter. In 1915 he became ill, possibly from lead poisoning from the paints he used, and gave up painting. Floodplain by Olga Wissinger Florian in 1926. Wissinger Florian was an Austrian Impressionist painter, mainly of landscapes and flower still life. She was a representative of the Austrian mood Impressionism, a loose group of Austrian Impressionist painters that was considered avant-garde in the 1870s and 1880s. The Valley of the Seine from the Hills of Giverny by Theodore Robinson in 1892. Robinson was an American painter best known for his Impressionist landscapes. He was one of the first American artists to take up Impressionism in the late 1880s, visiting Giverny and developing a close friendship with Claude Monet. The Plain of Auvers by Vincent van Gogh in 1890. Van Gogh was a Dutch post-impressionist painter who posthumously became one of the most famous and influential figures in the history of Western art. In just one decade, he created about 21 artworks, including around 860 oil paintings, most of which date from the last 2 years of his life. The Storm by Walter Withers in 1896. Withers was an English-born Australian landscape artist and a member of the Heidelberg School of Australian Impressionists. His influence as a painter upon younger art students of his time was marked. polder landscape with windmill near Upcowed by Willem Roelofs in 1870. Roelofs was a Dutch painter, watercolorist, etcher, lithographer, and draughtsman. He was one of the forerunners of the Dutch Revival art. After the Romantic classicism of the beginning of the 19th century, which led to the formation of the Hague School,